Okay, I am
And
taking
welcome
pictures.
back. This is hour 20 of 24 terrible hours. I feel
Oh,
like we're
dear
in the home
God.
stretch.
Oh,
It's
Daddy.
really starting to hurt. I am Boots Raingear. I am here. I don't even
Still
know
using
who I'm
your
here
own
with.
name. You're here with JW Friedman, that's for damn sure, son.
Yeah. Wait,
Oh,
let's
shit.
just take a moment and watch what's happening on
Yeah, what's going on in the Oh. No. Meanwhile, I have taken I have taken pictures of the coffee chips, and it's starting to smell really bad. So I think I will take my first bite,
Oh, yeah, so Montrith,
drink.
as a donation incentive, once we reached $3,000, has agreed to well, tell us what you're about to eat.
This is a salt and vinegar potato chips soaked in ice latte macchiato.
Is this a Finnish delicacy?
No, this is something that I thought was a good idea last night, and then I didn't eat it, and then I said, if we get over 3,000, I will eat it. Drink it. I don't know. It's half liquid, half potato chips.
I've spent the last 20 hours regretting things I thought was a good idea last night.
Okay, I'm gonna have to. Oh my God. Okay, it's not so bad. It's just one chip. And the coffee's kind of. Oh God, now the vinegar's hitting. Okay. Now I can do this. I will chew it quickly. No, I won't. Oh my God, this is so bad. Okay, I have to do it quickly because the more I will flavor the coffee, I will have a chip. Don't know if you can hear the crunch. It's not
Oh.
very crunchy anymore.
Oh.
Okay, it's turning into mush now. I might need a spoon.
I'm cutting you off, Montrith.
Okay, no, I said I will finish this and I will finish this coffee.
Okay.
Hold on, I will try to take one more chuck.
I'm awaiting the visual evidence of this. I also have confirmation the lemon is in fact alive, so that's nice.
Okay, I got one more swig left. I will take a picture to prove I have been eating this. And now I will have some more chips because I've been just having the coffee.
Okay.
Yeah.
Stop.
The chips are by
We
far
still
the
haven't
most
introduced
disgusting.
everybody.
Ugh.
No, this is almost over. I'm almost done.
Let her play. Let
Okay,
her
fine.
play.
Fuck
I will do this.
it.
Hold on, there's just a couple of more chips.
We'll do it live. Fuck it.
And the cover. Did it. I ate it all. I drank it all.
Are you sure you
Something
got
like
all?
that.
You think there might be some more in there?
I mean, there's some in my mouth, but this
Mm.
can't. Okay, I will be perfect. I will have the tiny little remains that are still in my cup. I really should have had
Okay,
a spoon.
no. Stop. All right. Hey, Lemon.
Hello.
How
Hey.
you doing?
Hey. Lemon.
More.
As you can see, the stream is still going very smoothly and everything's great.
Oh, you know, that's
There we
great.
go.
Lemon.
Oh, Lemon.
I am so in love and impressed with you people.
I'm having the last handful of chips in coffee.
So
I'm
excited.
losing my goddamn mind.
Oh, Poots,
Some somebody introduce shit. I'm gonna fix the website.
Boots, you're still
My
doing it.
mug
It's
is
great.
empty. I have done
Okay.
it.
Okay, we're on the Indigo children,
We
right?
sure are.
Oh, I got you, baby. Just take a moment.
You're my fucking hero.
Just take a moment, baby.
I seriously, I'm crying.
Oh my god.
Okay. Jeez. Okay, have we
you poor thing sitting in the chair.
No, we just spent 10 minutes listening to Montrith eat chips.
Okay. It's fine. Okay.
I'm done.
Okay.
Did it.
Yeah, no, we're gonna talk about the Indigo Society. We're gonna need to be looking at the document here, okay?
I might need to mute myself for a moment.
Because water. I think it was Boots Reingear that pointed out that this this document was actually submitted to the F Plus while Barack Obama was still president.
No, well, he was still in his first term.
Yeah. Oh,
it's crazy that he submitted a doc to us while he was president.
So this is an old thing. So look here at the document, and we're gonna talk about the Indigo Starter Kit. Adam, do you think you can tell us about the Indigo Starter Kit?
Sure.
Fantastic.
The Indigo Starter Kit. What to do after you find out? So you broke down and took the quiz after all your friends swear that you must be an Indigo child or Indigo adult. Now what? Welcome to a simple and free guide to get you set up and running as a newly discovered Indigo person. If you haven't already, invest in some surge protectors for your electronics. Indigo mood swings are notorious for shorting out light bulbs and frying computers. Wait, do Indigo children have electricity powers? What's going on?
Okay, so Indigo children are, timeless beings.
Right.
Who are old souls and are, let's see, they're old souls.
They're magical, right?
You know how when your kid... Okay, so you know how when your kid is the best thing ever and way better than all the other kids?
I do, actually.
This is like a scientific way of saying that your kid is the best, most bestest kid because they have psychic abilities and they're really good.
Well, thanks for providing science. That's nice.
Is this like when your 3-year-old, you know, like watches TV and sees Donald Trump and then and is like, why does the bad man want to take away our rights? And then you write it on Twitter and get 20,000 retweets.
It's like that, but the child knows that he's lying because they have psychic abilities and are connected to aliens or something.
Why does the man hate different people? Oh, honey, the wisdom of babes. Yes.
Clear out the clutter and mess in your home ASAP. Messiness is a magnet for dark energy and negative spirits. You don't want to deal with them just yet. You might even want to do a thorough sage smudging or cleansing ritual for good measure. Keep it to yourself. Learn about everything. Make Indigo friends online, but don't come out of the closet until you understand yourself better. Can't sleep? Move all the electronics out of the bedroom. Can't manage to part with your wall of electronics you so carefully set up? Put the whole setup on a surge protector power strip with a master switch on it so you can turn the power off on everything. I highly recommend an Indigo Optimum diet, mostly fruits and vegetables, whole grains and nuts. Can't go total veggie? Then cut back on animal products or substitute them with veggie equivalents. No soda or coffee, herbal teas, and juice that has been watered down a little, lots of water. Choose fresh over processed and natural over junk. Can't do it? Just cut back. Stop taking recreational drugs and drinking alcohol. Let your body reset itself.
Hey, hippies, no more pot, okay?
I know, like, what is... I really mischaracterized what Indigo children were because it really does sound like, you know, they're that kid from that Michael Shannon movie who has... got to wear like goggles on his eyes. What's that movie? What's that movie with a kid in it? He's special.
Powder? Lucas?
No, not Lucas or Powder.
Is it Back to the Future?
It's kids. It's Larry Clark's kids. That's what I'm thinking.
Oh,
those are not special kids.
Motherfucker.
Special powers are being inappropriately sexualized.
I'm not gonna lie, starting to feel a little bit bad.
Why? Why are you starting to feel bad?
For some reason.
Midnight Express. Midnight Express.
Midnight Express. Thank you.
Sorry.
So stop taking recreational drugs. Maybe you'll feel better. avoid negative people and cultivate relationships with positive people. Renew your faith. Don't believe in anything. Study religion and spirituality and find one that calls to you.
Religion in general.
Atheists. this by no means is a complete list, but it is enough to get you over some common new indigo problems. Many will disagree with this list, and many will cheer. Use your intuition about what seems right for you and everything in life. In other words, is your child a child?
That's what? Ominous.
Okay. Okay, there okay.
There's a quiz.
Yeah, no, I'm excited for the quiz because I think that, you know, I have a child, and of course... And of course, I'm wondering if my child is an indigo child. before we get to that, though, let's start out with introducing the room, which I don't think it happened.
The real pro shop you're running here, folks.
It's hour 20, and I have nothing but admiration for Boots Rain Gear for getting here. because I got to hour like 12 and then
you died
and then exploded out of my holes and then had 2 hours of a panic attack.
Yeah, so
you had Soylent too.
What?
Oh yeah, you've missed a lot of things.
I'm a ticking time bomb.
Yeah. Did you have Soylent?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I chugged it.
He had coffee.
It was coffeeist, so it also had caffeine in it for extra digestive action.
Also, we still haven't made it through the intros.
Okay, yeah. In the room for this hour, we are reading about the Indigo Children, as you might have imagined. This is a document that Montrith provided to us very, very long ago. And I got Adam Bozarth. Hello.
Hello.
A little bit of Boots Rain Gear, but, you know, he should be sitting back drinking some Gatorade.
I'm setting up the show off Montrith's photos here.
Okay, excellent. And don't put any more Monster Energy drink in you, please.
You weren't here for Ultra Blue. It was worse.
Okay. what might be the first hour of J.W. Friedman? Is that correct?
Yeah, one of those.
Shit, how exciting. Then we've got Frank West. Hi.
Hey, it's me. I woke up only a little bit before you did.
Okay, got a little bit of sleep. That's nice. And then there's Achilles Healy's.
Hi, I'm along for the ride.
Okay, great. And you might be doing butt things at some point.
Is that a threat?
Well, you remember, you've got to bend over on the couch.
I remember.
You've got to start soft.
Which is Soylent related butt things.
Yeah.
Why did it go back to this nonsense immediately when I came back?
It's fine.
Because you submitted this document, Montrith.
Yeah.
We haven't even read the document, like, with one post in.
We have a document?
And, it's fine. And our artist, I'm so glad to be seeing some more sanguinary novel. But anyway, and Montrith's here. Hi, Montrith.
Hi.
But I've been wondering if my child is an indigo child. So, Mr. J.W. Friedman, do you think you could give me a test?
I don't know. Are you ready to get real?
Yeah, absolutely I am.
Indigo Child's Quiz. Number one, does your child expect to be treated as an equal instead of a child?
No, not really.
Okay, bad. All right. Is your child easily emotionally triggered?
Yeah, yep.
Oh, she's a snowflake cuck.
Yep.
Oh my God. Hey, honey. This is called Reddit. You're gonna super like it.
Dear Reddit, why is my child such a cock?
Your child have difficulty with discipline and authority.
Sometimes, sure. I'm gonna say yeah.
Sad. Is your child frustrated with ritual-oriented systems that require little creativity?
Frustrated? I mean, sure, of course. Yes, of course, yeah.
Diphtheria. All right, so does your child have a gentle, sensitive spirit and caring heart?
I think so, yep.
Does your child have food or environmental sensibilities?
Does your child react to things? Is that what that question is?
It's kind of what it sounds like, yeah.
Food sensibilities? Yes, yes. My daughter knows what things taste like. Yes, absolutely.
No. Sensitivities.
Oh, sensitivities. Oh, environmental sensitivities. Yeah, I mean, yeah, she won't eat a whole bunch of shit. Yeah.
And, every living creature is reacting to your environment is an important part of the living organism.
Well, I think you'll see as we're at question 7 of 23 that by the end here, you're fucking on to something. Does your child dislike being rushed or not seem to have a sense of time in a traditional way?
Yes,
because it's a child.
Spiritual things.
He likes Ghostbusters.
Here it comes. Does your child appear to be an old soul or wise beyond their years?
I don't think that's on the child. I think that's my fault at that point.
Yeah.
Whoa, my kid is so smart, so much smarter than I am.
All my kid will talk about is Felix the Cat and these three weird Victorian novels I let them read.
He's such an old soul.
let's move a little further here. Right. Let's jump down to where, because things get a little unimportant, but then they get really important again.
So I could apply almost every single one of these to any cat.
Yeah.
Oh, especially number 11.
But number 11 is good. Did your child come into the world with an attitude?
Hell yeah.
Well then, give me a hell yeah.
She was wearing one of those bad boy shirts, you know, with like angry eyes on it.
My child came into the world and like smashed two beer cans together and then like flipped people off and said, hell yeah.
Jeff out.
Yeah. My kid's first words were, vibe.
And that's the bottom line, because the Indigo child said so. Is your child a nonconformist?
Again, conflict.
Is your child particular?
Is your child Boss Baby?
Ooh, here's a good one. Does your child talk to or about imaginary friends to see things that you cannot? Does your child refuse?
Tell your child immediately all those things are real and they are super smart for seeing them, and that will not fuck them up at all.
Again, cat, like.
Here's the important thing. If you answered yes to more than 14 of these, like, 27,000 questions I just read a few of, you are probably parenting an Indigo or are an Indigo. If your score is above 19, you are almost definitely parenting an Indigo child. This quiz has been developed from a combination of people including Lee Carroll, Jan Tober, Doreen Virtue, Jan Yorty, and Vicky Lass.
Okay, so...
You know,
so
it's legit.
It is legit. I can tell that. great. So my child, it turns out, is an Indigo child. That's fantastic. So good. That means that they're ageless and like perfect. Is that right?
Yeah. Yeah, and very smart, and they're good at music, and they're really actually old souls. They have problems with ritual-oriented systems and shit, but it's because they're just so fucking creative.
Right,
they're here from another dimension they're manic pixie dream children.
Oh, and I forgot that Indigo children are also, I think, time travelers who are here to save the world from collapse.
And well, you are an Indigo parent, Lemon.
Probably. Who you're talking to.
Okay. We're gonna scroll down. Indigo Society, since this document was submitted, has been taken offline, or not offline, but like a lot of these actual links are dead.
It's weird how time happens.
Yeah, no, that's odd. That's odd.
Doesn't happen fast enough. Hey, I've got some screenshots of, not screenshots, some images taken that Montrith took of what we heard her eat about 20 minutes ago.
Okay.
Do we want to all take a look at that?
Sure.
Here's the first picture.
Actually, I don't want to look at that, so
yeah, you can look away. That's fine.
I don't want to think what's inside.
So Montrith, remind us what we're looking at.
Oh, that looks tasty.
It's salt and vinegar chips in an iced macchiato.
Jesus Christ.
All right, here's image number two. Also, pre-consumption. Three makes less sense. Did you just add more chips to it?
No, it's just farther away.
Okay.
Okay, so here's the thing, right? Like, I'm colorblind, and I can almost imagine that's like queso or some kind of cheese dip.
And here's the final results. Everything that was in that cup is now in Montrith. May God rest your soul.
No, that's the middle result. There is still the empty cup to prove it. So, there it is. So I was lagging.
Oh, yeah, okay.
I ate it all, you bitches.
What a sport.
All right. Let's talk about some difficulties with the box, shall we?
We all got them.
So this is what my voice sounds like. You just have to deal with that fact. Okay, so hello all. I'm Halo. New. Hey, hello all. I'm new, and it's a good place to find. That's a good to find a place with like-spirited individuals. You know, because like-minded is just annoying enough. I know this is an introduction thread, but I do have a problem and could use some help. I'm having difficulty with communication due to seeing from a different perspective. I like analogies, and the box seems to represent my issues in communication. Picture a box.
Okay.
Hmm.
Got it.
Yep. Great. When Hang I on. Talk...
Oh, wait. Okay, got it.
There we go. I like analogies. And the box seems to be represent. Oh, yeah. When I talk to people, I can see inside the box and outside the box and the possible links to other boxes.
Linked boxes, okay.
However, the people I talk to can only see the box, specifically when they are positioned inside the box. These different perspectives cause a lot of frustration, which leads to anger.
And sometimes you gotta shove your nose in shit.
Now, I'm feeling some anger.
I'm sorry.
I get angry because I feel as though I'm communicating in a very, very simple terms, but the person opposite of me can't see it. The person opposite of me can only see left, right, front, and back of them. Like Time Cube, but for assholes. Wait.
This is completely Time Cube. You were educated stupid.
It's like communicating on two different levels. I always run into issues with people who think they see the big picture, but it's actually a smaller picture. And when I talk about the big picture, there are people listening says, I made it up. Does anyone else have this problem? Any suggestions would be helpful. Thanks. And Achilles, you have the response to that?
That is a very interesting way to describe your thought process during conversations. I can relate very strongly to it. I can see inside the box and outside, and by the time somebody has the picture of the whole box in their mind, I can already see 10 more boxes. Probably like 10 more than you can. This causes me frustration and apathy.
Aww.
I get tired of people and trying to communicate or talk to them. I construct the other boxes, other ideas, other subjects, new perspectives, in very simple terms. But the person seems unable to escape their current box. It absolutely is like communicating on two different levels. I am constantly building up the parts to make more big pictures.
What do you think about the time-traveling space aliens? What? Oh, you can't see the box.
This is going to turn into that Futurama episode any moment here. Mm-hmm. You go to the box and then go up the other box?
The box says no.
I feel like you're writing a very good analogy for my mind here, especially with how a person...
analogy was in quotes, too.
Especially with how a person might have the big picture, but that big picture is just a smaller piece of the next bigger picture. But holy, they are clueless shit. When I begin to guide the conversation to the bigger idea. They have no idea why I'm bringing up those ideas outside of their box. They think I just randomly made it up, and it has nothing to do with what they are thinking.
And then they get up and move across the aisle from me on the bus for no reason.
But you haven't looked at my zine yet. It makes me apathetic, makes me not care. I purposely make my own thoughts dumber and more quiet so that I can tolerate people. Nobody has ever been able to give me such a good example. I am also new. Welcome to the Thought Forum.
We're going to skip down just a little bit. This discussion goes on for a while, but I'm enjoying this this thread, which is called, I Have Problem with Friendship. So we're going to start off with Frank West here. And Frank West, what do you got to talk about?
I have problem with friendship. I can easily make friends, but it won't last long. I wonder why. They always ended up dislike me. I don't know what's wrong. Maybe there's something wrong with my attitude. I never say rude words.
Okay. Kelly Seeley's first response, please.
Oh, hey. I have slight troubles making friends because I don't like to bond. Well, I can you. Say the reason.
Fuck you. I don't like making friends because I don't make friends.
That's the problem. It's not me. I can see the reason for them not liking you. It's probably because you are light. Their dark side likes to bully someone. And you're an obvious target. I have this with my own friends. One does nothing wrong, yet I get annoyed at him. There's nothing wrong with him. I'm just looking for someone to be annoyed at.
Wow, that's the great. You just walk around finding, like, okay, who's going to be annoying today?
Yeah, they just don't see, Mike, the boxes.
Which one of y'all is going to annoy the Indigo child? I have the same problem. It's not you who has the problem. It's society! It's like the shortest Monty Python sketch right there.
Look, what's more likely, that I'm imperfect or that every single other person ever has a problem?
I'm a loner. Always I prefer it that way. But I also know I am quite entertaining, cute, and experienced in life that people just flock to me. Hunt me down.
You're pretty cute.
Lol. Courtesy of my ego and me. But seriously, I never realized I had such a wide circle of acquaintances. Acquaintances.
That's a sad term to use. Things are not going well in your life if you use circle of acquaintances.
The wide circle of acquaintances.
Assemble the circle of acquaintances.
my circle of acquaintances back surround me. I know I can always text them and they might read it.
Sometimes
I'm
like
a part of a circle of acquaintances. You know?
It's the circle of acquaintances.
Even though I prefer to be alone, people get amazed on how many people I know.
400 Facebook friends! Holy shit!
I know all of them. Reasons why I'd have to cut someone off. Number one, not humble, showing haughtiness or superior attitude toward others. Number two, showing little to no respect. Self-explanatory.
By the way, I'm the best human that's ever been born.
Number three, lying, being a two-faced reveler. Self-explanatory. Number four, constant negativity, drama. That old saying, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. You should hear the things I say to people and get away with. It's so true. Use tact. Be lovable. Never lie. Better be helpful and listen. Maybe you can try recording yourself, talking to others. Listen to it and see if you like what you hear.
Yeah, that's how self-awareness works. You're right. You basically figured it out.
Yeah, like watching football plays in the film room.
Do you like Huey Lewis in the news?
Why are you putting on that raincoat right now? Montrith, take the post that starts, I am sorry when I lose a friend.
Okay. I am sorry when I lose a friend, either by being dumb or by choosing not to be with them anymore. However, I am growing and changing so fast that most of my friends can't keep up or don't want to. It is a good job.
Yay! Yay!
It isn't the judgment, just the resonance thing. When I was beginning to read about Indigo children and develop my gifts, many of my closest friends abandoned me. They did not want to know about meditation and discipline and diet to be a better, more evolved psychic. They just wanted me to be the same and give them the attention they were accustomed to. I had changed. I was no longer willing to play the role they were used to. So they just resonated right out of my experience. I still grieve about that, but it was so worth it for me to grow and become who I believe I was born to be. I make friends all the time. Some leave and some remain. I celebrate all who come into my life and send those who leave it away with love. Everything changes and will keep changing.
Man, these poor special people. I can't imagine what it's like to lose a friend over time.
I know, and like, could you possibly think it might be difficult to have friends? That sounds so strange and unheard of. Like, also, it's almost like meeting people as an adult is kind of difficult.
I'm really sorry about the voice, but I think I just pulled something in my throat and it got stuck like that. I couldn't get out of it.
Well, that's your indigo spirit. Just harness it.
Oh, we got to read the next one, though. Cause
I was going to say, I feel like some of these people are having difficulties being likable. But Frank West, this one seems pretty likable. Why don't you take that?
Which one?
Starts well, ..
Well, I mean, do you know Family Complex from Mikio Tsuda?
Oh, okay. No, I don't. Should I familiarize myself in order to be friends with you?
Is there a Western equivalent?
Oh, don't worry about that. I'll familiarize you. How many hours do you have? One of the character called Harumi Sakamoto. I guess I'm a bit like him. But for me, people always talk to me first, or called me first. Very long pause. How to describe it?
extremely long pause.
Oh, maybe. Equals people said I'm not the pretty, I'm the prettiest in class, or maybe just pretty. Not trying to sound arrogant. I'm not enjoying it. But no one is really trying to flirt me. Maybe it's because I'm taller and mysterious. But from what I see, I'm not really the prettiest. So there are some more girls who look more cute and, well, girly. So...
Boss, that's long enough for me to go to the bathroom.
Nej, to the point. Do you think my words are confusing? What the fuck is that emoticon? Even I can't do it.
Pronounce it.
That's a sunglasses and nose and long mouth.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
I can sunglasses. See it.
Yep, there it is.
Oh, yeah. And then the question mark threw me off.
And then it's got like, yeah, like a big chin. Like a.
Do you think my words are confusing?
Do I know the face sideways?
I think that's Jay Moore. That emoticon.
It's an emoticon of Jay Moore.
Yeah, so I googled Family Complex because I thought the name seemed familiar, and yes, it is a comic I actually read.
Excellent.
When I was in high school, and it's basically yaoi for girls who don't like sex.
Whoa. All right,
that raises way too many questions.
Yeah, yeah.
that's another document
next hour.
it's the kind of like bullshit, like you know, we'll do anything that is in yaoi except actually have the guys be together, because
because
women are really repressed and they don't actually want to read about sex or something like that.
So
kind of like what would you, if you had to give a yaoi to a Christian, very Christian girl, this is the kind you would give.
So scrolling down here to page 9, and Adam Bozarth, what happened last night when you were meditating?
Last night, while I was meditating, a memory from my childhood surfaced. It was not some major event, but rather a question I asked my mother when I was around 6 years old. I'm not sure what prompted me to ask her this question, but it was, if I was never born, would I be someone else?
Oh, okay.
Guys.
Okay. Yep.
Guys.
Yep.
Yeah. She looked at me strangely, and I could sense that she had never pondered such a question.
I can't recall
what she said, but in short, her answer was no.
as she laid her palm against your face and pushed you out of the kitchen.
This answer didn't satisfy me because I felt she didn't fully understand what I was asking. In retrospect, I imagine it would have been a bit confusing for her to hear such a question from her 6-year-old son, Lowell.
Well.
Anyway, the fact that I asked this question tells me that even at a young age, I understood that I was more than just a physical body. What I was really asking was, if I had not been conceived and born... when I had, would my soul or consciousness have chosen another human being to inhabit? How did my stupid mother not understand this simple question?
What I meant to say was the same thing, but with more words involved.
Hey, remember when I was a kid and my parents thought I was the most intelligent person ever? Turns out they were right.
It's an interesting question. I think it's an interesting question that I am still unsure of how to answer. Does anyone else have an opinion on this? Anyone?
And presumably nobody does.
Oh, of course.
Your post is not about me, so going to the next one. all right, let's scroll down a little bit more. And this is Apollo speaking. We're on page 12 now. Hello, many friends.
Apologies, circle of acquaintances.
Hello, everyone who likes me. The name is Up to Quark. I am a weary wanderer in the color of rainbows. I founded myself upon my own gridwork and hope to establish a new age of physics in this three-dimensional realm.
Dimensional.
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 Yeah, dimensional. Yeah.
Dimensional. Ask your doctor about dimensional.
My work.
Do you or someone in your family suffer from dimensional? Did you know the government has set aside billions of dollars for settlements?
Okay. My work is under progress, or under process, whatever that means. Yeah. And I, as a loner, contemplate what I feel. I have spiritual guides and also guides in this dimension who are working with me to establish my abilities as a seer. I am an indigo child by birth, but also I am a rainbow child due to the birth or awakening in later years. I hope to get to know all of you. If you have any questions, give me a shout. And nobody did.
So do indigo children work like the Green Lantern Corps or something? Like,
I was thinking more like Captain Planet team, but they definitely like they have a sense of when they're near each other for sure.
Oh yeah, yeah. Absolutely.
I think there are parts of the world that are like conclaves of indigo children, and the magic level is so fucking high.
Mm-hmm. You mean like magic cards?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Also tarot, if you count the parents.
Oh, that's more likely, yeah.
All right, so scrolling down, and I'm excited about this one. Frank West, I think. This thread is called Houston, We Have a Problem.
Houston, we have a problem. Okay, so lately I've been having trouble with one of the buttons on my laptop. Like when my brother uses it, I swear to God that he puts some kind of bad juju on the button. Then I come along and I'm like, what the fuck? Tapping the button normal won't work. I literally have to use my gift just to get the damn button. Wait, you can't. I read that without really getting it.
So, yeah, my gift.
To get the damn button to work. I mean, he so much as looks at the laptop and it's broken.
Okay.
So my question is, how do you teach a non-sensitive psychic to control their shit? I mean, serious. I wave my finger in the air, gain some static, push the button, and it work. It's worked since I did that once. Then he come around, clicks it one time, and it does not work anymore, and I have to charm the damn button again. I'm really frustrated now.
Oh, hello, button.
I just saw that J.W. Friedman has a request for Macho Man Randy Savage, and I think that this response here that starts, lol, I zapped it, is exactly the correct choice. So, yeah, Jay, take it.
Lol, I zapped it once and it's fixed. I just don't understand how he could get it not to respond like he did. I mean,
yeah!
If he fried the circuit temporarily, dig it. I mean, I have no ideas, but yeah, I mean, I brought it back to life 3 times already. Yeah, and if he so much as touches the computer, I'll zap him next. Dig it. For electric KD fib lol. So if I say I had to defib the PC, folks will know that. And the term NAF, new age mind fuck, yeah, brother, has been added to my word bank. Damn,
he's got him the new age mind fuck.
featuring Mr. Ass Billy Gunn. Damn, I'm either going to have to be rich or Jesus in like a year. Dig it. Yeah, freak out, brother.
Thank you very much, Macho Man.
Get rich or get Jesus trying.
Terrific. Very last thing here in this doc we're going to read, and it's the one that starts CK... Achilles, you think you can take that one?
Wow. Sure, once I find that.
Yeah.
Oh, I think this needs a little bit of backstory
before we read it.
Skillet was this person who was really, really prolific on this forum, and he basically only had one topic he ever talked about, and that was that if his family would just give him $20,000 and a garage, then he could write a Grammy-winning album.
Any garage?
With his psychic abilities?
I don't know if he any had any, because he only talked about the fact that he couldn't have a career as a musician because his family wouldn't give him $20,000.
Jesus.
Yeah, so this this post is in response to one of Skillet's threads where he's again complaining about his family not giving him the money and the garage.
Just want to say, our most recent donator right now is named Glitter Tits, which is a name I enjoy very much.
Yes.
Yes. All right. Well, Skillet, dear old boy Skillet, you know what's your problems? It's not your family as an obstacle. Don't even choose them as black sheeps. I'll help you. The biggest obstacle in the path to reach your dreams is you. Simple answer, isn't it? You actually allow other people's comments and argumentations to affirm yourself that you're have no potential to make your dreams come true.
Argumentations.
Instead of believing your inner strength to say yes to your dream. You prefer to believe words from your family. No wonder. Long pause. Look, don't make any disturbance opinions around you makes you unfocused to your dream.
Just read the text. That's all you need to do.
The more you hear all negative words from others, bye-bye to your dreams.
Bye-bye.
Again, it's not about other people, it's about you.
Finally, someone said it.
Speaking of huge selling hit, elements and selling experience, the knowledge to make songs that commercially successful. Whoa! Stop right there, buddy!
Rap album, brother.
Self-confidence is totally good. Overconfidence! Is something else, I'm afraid. To reach your goals, work smart, not work hard. Every steps of your way, from one step to another, make a time to evaluate yourself and ask, have I done my work correctly? What's my next move? Do I need any correction? Whom should I ask to work with? Now that's, my dear friend, what I call dickipline.
Ask your doctor about disipline.
Disipline.
Master, what is disipline?
Did you do everything correct?
If you haven't built your posture, attitude, working habit as a winner, please do allow me to say this. Bye-bye, Grammy, just me. P.S. Work with more positive people and read more character-building books. Not the nasty book.
Amy points out that this kind of reads like Talking Heads lyrics.
Stop it, everybody! Self-confidence is a total good.
Imagine yourself, not the nasty book.
I think Jay, is that JW Friedman as Macho Man Randy Savage right there?
Shooting psychic out of his psychic power out of his hands.
I seriously believe it might be, and it makes me happier than most things have made me over the past few years.
Nuking brother. Let me tell you. Nothing that makes a man feel better than seeing a good drawing of himself over here.
Fantastic. So that was the Indigo Children Hour. Thanks so much.
Really quickly say something?
Yes,
I think the last sentence in this talk pretty much will summarizes the whole Indigo Society forums, and I will post it here and maybe someone can read it.
Oh, I want to take this.
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe I'm just an ordinary psychic kid.
Coming now to Fox Kids. So we will be back after a break with Metabods aiming to perfect gay pornography.
Yay!
Looks like that's got Lemon, Achilles, Healy's, Adam Bozarth, Kumquat Sop, J.W. Friedman, Boots, take a breather. It's fine.
Yeah, I'm going to find lunch?
Sure,
find a lunch.
10-minute lunch, the best kind.
Yeah, absolutely. So we'll be back real soon. Take a lap.
Yeah. I'll be in the chat.